name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The tenth station of the cross, Jesus is stripped of his garments. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. So, as we've done before, let's just put ourselves before a station, an image of the tenth station, Jesus being stripped, or even before an image from a movie, and kind of silence our hearts. Have you noticed during the virus, a lot of things have been stripped away? What our hobbies are, we mostly can't do anymore. Some of our work has been radically affected. Parents that have other occupations now are kind of becoming substitute teachers. Some of them are becoming wardens because they're trying to, you know, wrangle their little ones into studying. There's going to be a great appreciation for teachers at the end of this experience. But, you know, all of this has sort of stripped us of these false identities. And yet, at the same time, I wonder what it's revealed in you. I wonder what's come out of you. Have you become a little bit more self-aware? Have you become a little bit more aware of the things that you like about yourself and the things that you don't like? Have you spent a fair amount of time murmuring and mumbling about what's wrong with the world or what's wrong with those people around you? Why your kids act like that? It's not the way you acted. Of course, you were a little saint when you grew up. But the point of all of that is whenever anything is stripped away, it's always going to reveal something very profound. Authenticity, truth. I imagine when they stripped Jesus, which was part of the Roman ritual of humiliation, exposing a Jewish man before men and women, etc. I imagine the intention of those that were involved in this act was just to completely demoralize Jesus. And yet what's happened is by the stripping, we actually see something even more profound. We see, besides the utter abasement of God, we are struck by what has been torn away has revealed a suffering servant. So in the act of those who persecuted Christ, who whipped Christ, they thought, aha, this will totally demoralize him. But in effect, what it's done is it's created an interior love in most of us, or a devotion to the wounds of Jesus, not just on the cross, but those wounds on his back, and elsewhere throughout his body, in which he received on the journey to Calvary. The point is that when God allows something to be stripped away, it's going to reveal an opportunity for something very profound to come forth. The truth underneath all of the masks that we have, all of those things that we have self-identified. This is who I am, okay? I would like you to spend a little time, if you will, today thinking of, like, what is it like when you just kind of strip everything away? What remains? Well, there's a couple of things that remain. First, your identity as a child of God. When Jesus stands on Calvary, completely stripped, he is the Son of the Father. He can no longer perform actions, miracles, liberations, deliverances, but he actually stands there with an identity. Secondly, he does not stand there alone. Yes, we know that Mary Magdala, Salome, Our Lady, John. There's people in the crowd, some who are for him and some who are against him. But he doesn't stand there alone, but he stands there with a purpose, a greater purpose, not just to do acts, but to be present to God the Father, and to be present to others. And finally, what you realize is that you see the utter reality of God's love. It's all stripped away, and this is now love that stands before us. I think the same is true for us when all of this stuff that's been stripped away, you know, we can't do the things we want to do. And what's left? First, you stand as a child of God now. Wherever you are and whatever is going on in your life, you are a child of God. Second is to realize very profoundly that whatever God has taken away, it's to reveal something more, that you're not alone. You're not alone in the mystery of this experience of this virus. Thirdly is to really understand that by the stripping away, God also reveals to others our love for them. All of this virus experience has actually been a blessing for those that have not let the little things get in the way. It's not been something where people who are just going to be excessively frustrated or critical about little things, all of that's going to fade. At least it should. Because at the mountain, everything now is just, it's just Christ, the Father, the cross, and a few that love him. So today, as you kind of chew on these things, what is the Lord trying to strip away? Are you accepting of your body? Are you accepting of your finances? Are you accepting of the things that are going on with your kids or whatever? And all those things that maybe God is stripping away, are you there to trust that you are a child of God and that he's loving you in that place? Everything changes and you can remain at peace. My worry actually is not those of you that are listening to the videos. My worry is for those that aren't. My worry is for those who are just letting things overwhelm them all the time. It's going to have a very, very serious crippling effect on the kids. It's going to be recovery time after the virus. So I want you to reach out to folks and tell them, hey, look, you're not a teacher. Relax. Everything is not going to be perfect, but we do our best. It's something very beautiful. Just imagine, you know, what it'll be like even when it comes to the kiddos and when we gather again in schools. Something will be different. Maybe we come back with a different attitude and disposition. May the Lord give you some insight that whatever is being stripped away with God's love, it's just revealing something. And hopefully it's revealing your love, that you're not alone, and your willingness to really suffer so that God's love can be revealed. And may Almighty God bless you folks, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.